We were all refugees. We were trying to do our best to exist, to stay alive, and to continue our lives as best we can.
In that days, in Paris, for a young man to walk on the street was dangerous. They could just grab him and take him away to fight in the war. So the Rebbe went to sign up for the army. He got a certificate that he is a registered recruit. With this certificate, it was easy for him to walk on the street. If a police stops him and says, "Where are your papers?" he shows that he is a recruit.
The managers of the hotel or the administrators had realized that my husband barely eats anything, so they would try to collect and hide sugar, extra sugar to give to, you know, and they would give it to me for my husband.
Through a group of activists and attorneys led by the previous Rebbe, visa applications were submitted requesting special non-quota visas, explaining that the Rebbe was a part of the hierarchy of the Lubavitch movement. However, a regular visa application had already been submitted, pointing to his expertise as an engineer. The apparent conflict seems to have raised the skepticism of the U.S. State Department in Washington, and they refused to issue the special visas.
At that time, it was about 300,000 Jews in France, and Rebbe Schneerson was one of them. He registered with Hayes, and Hayes picked up the case. They advised him that to try to get visa as a Russian refugee will be much easier than insisting on non-quota visa as a rabbi.
They were afraid of German submarines. They had big names, Portugal, painted on the sides of the ship. And they had floodlights to light up this name so that if there were any subs that surfaced and looked at the name of that particular ship, they would know that it was a Portuguese ship and they would leave it alone.
Order the early years today at gemstore.com.